Welcome back, linguists. Today I'd like to talk to you about phonetics, the smallest possible aspect of linguistics. So phonetics is the study of the physical properties of speech sounds or signs. So the study of phonetics, or the study of the sounds that are used to create words that contribute to language. We call these separate sounds phones. For example, take the word dog in English. Dog is made up of three separate sounds, d, a, g. And likewise, the word cat. Cat is also made up of three separate sounds, k, a, t. Those sounds in dog and cat are phones, and you can see by comparing them that the three phones of dog are separate and distinct and different than the three phones that you find in the word cat. Now, dog and cat both happen to have three sounds apiece, and they also happen to be spelled with three letters each. But remember that that's just a coincidence. Writing has absolutely nothing to do with what we're talking about when we talk about language in linguistics. So by and large, we can classify the sounds of a language into two major classes, consonants and vowels. So if you look at a poem like this, this poem is by Neal Whitman, and it contains all of the sounds of the English language. The pleasure of Shun's company is what I most enjoy. He put a tack on Miss Yancey's chair when she called him a horrible boy. At the end of the month, he was flinging two kittens across the width of the room. I countered his schemes to show me a way now of getting away from my gloom. How many consonant sounds do you think you heard? How about vowel sounds? Take a minute and think about it. So how many vowels do you think there are in English? Well, you might have learned A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y, but again, that's a spelling thing and has very little to do with what we're talking about. Overall in English, there are about 11 plain vowels and 3 diphthongs in standard versions of the English language. We can describe the vowel sounds of English using a set of keywords to help us know which vowel we're talking about. In each of these keywords that I'm going to give you, the vowel sound in that word is the vowel that we'll be talking about. So, for example, the first vowel is the vowel as in the word fleece. And the fleece vowel makes the E sound. Fleece, E. Next we have kit, I, kit. Face, A, face. Dress, E, dress. Trap, A, trap. This is a bit silly, but okay. I'll continue. Goose. Ooh, goose. Foot. Foot. Goat. Oh, goat. Strut. Strut. Thought. Aw, thought. Lot. Lot. Those are the plain vowels of English. Along with that, you can also include the vowel schwa, which is a vowel that sounds kind of like eh. Schwa is used in unstressed syllables only. Finally, we have three major diphthongs in English. Oi, as in choice. I, as in price. And ow, as in mouth. Now, different dialects and accents are going to vary somewhat depending on which of these vowels that they have. For a lot of you out there, you're probably not going to have a distinction between the vowel in lot and the vowel in thought. So they probably both sound kind of like ah to you. Lot, thought. If you're not sure, ask yourself whether or not this thing, a caller, sounds different than somebody who calls you on the phone. A caller. Caller, collar, do they sound different to you or not? Those are the lot and thought vowels. And one of the major characteristics of American English is that most speakers, especially those people under the age of about 30, have merged these two vowels and now only have one vowel, where we used to have two. So, for the most part, vowels are always voiced, and they're always produced without any turbulence in the vocal channel, without any turbulence in your throat or your mouth. So, instead of describing things in terms of place and manner and voicing with vowels, we instead talk about where they feel like they're being produced in your mouth. The first distinction is whether they feel like they're being produced at the front or back of your mouth. And just a note on these descriptions, they worked for people who came up with the IPA chart 150, 200 years ago. whether or not you feel like these vowels feel more front or more back, if you don't feel it, then you don't feel it. Some people do, some people don't. So, the front vowels are vowels like fleece, kit, face, dress, and trap. Those contrast with the back vowels in English: goose, foot, goat, lot, thought, strut. So aside from frontness, backness, you can also think about how high the vowel is, or how high your jaw is. So vowel sounds made with a high tongue position and with a high jaw include fleece, kit, goose, and foot. Vowels produced with a low jaw and a low tongue position include trap, lot, and thought. You can just compare the difference. Lot, fleece, lot, fleece. And then we have vowels that are midway between that. They're called mid-vowels. And these include face, dress, goat, and strut. The jaw is neither fully high nor fully low. Your tongue is neither fully high nor fully low. It's kind of mid. And again, depending on who you are, what dialect you speak, what your accent is, these terms are going to be more or less literally applicable. Next, we can talk about whether or not vowels are round. In English, all of the back vowels are round vowels, and all of the front vowels are not round vowels. So, goose, foot. You can see how my lips round as I make those sounds. And that's what it means by saying that the vowel is round. Goose, foot, goat. And although English doesn't have any front round vowels, a lot of languages that you might know certainly do. So German, for example, has e, Müller. French has e, as in tu, je bu, I drank. I don't know, my French is not very good, but it has a front vowel sound, I promise. E, as in egg, if, e. These are the front vowels. And they can be made round just like the back vowels, it's just that English doesn't happen to do that. Finally, we can talk about the difference between diphthongs and monophthongs. Monophthongs are basically a single sound. All the vowels that we've been talking about so far are monophthongs. They're also called plain vowels sometimes. Diphthongs, on the other hand, are vowels that move throughout your mouth as you're saying them. I, oi, ow. Those are our three major diphthongs in English. Some people consider the face and goat vowels in English to also be diphthongs because the way English speakers produce these sounds, they move a lot more than they do in other languages, depending on who you are and how you pronounce it and what your dialect and what your accent is. Again, these things vary slightly from one speaker to another. And a lot of things happen in the world's languages that don't happen in English. So now that you know about the phonetics of English, you can apply that to your study of other languages and to anything else that you do when you go out and go a linguisting. See you next time!